I thought this morning that we'd spend our time meditation on mindfulness, and more specifically, mindfulness of emotions. Since they have such a powerful influence on our lives, I know for myself, particularly early in my life, emotions could kind of carry me away, would play a big part in how I reacted to things around me, and how I reacted to people and circumstances. And so, and emotion, I mean, things like joy and happiness and laughter, and also afflictive emotion, anger and fear, those kinds of things, which are all good to feel and be with and face, but it's good to be with them and recognize what they are, not get carried away with them. So I Ben Connolly is a Zen practitioner back in Minnesota, and he has a book that I really enjoy. So I'm drawing from this book a little bit. So I'm going to read a couple things out of his book, and then I invite you to go within. I'm going to chime my bowl to start the meditation, and I'll chime the bowl a second time to end the meditation, and then I'll have a little short reading. Even the best of us are generally not very mindful of our feelings. We're absorbed in the thought, believing the stories and the perceptions of the world our feelings create. For example, when angry, rather than being deeply aware of what it is like to experience anger, we just think about how someone else is wrong. When we're worried, rather than knowing the hard beating heart, the butterflies in our stomach, and the feeling of fear itself, we're just absorbed in a long line of thoughts about dreadful outcomes. Mindfulness of emotions requires deeply experiencing our feelings and letting go of our mind's focus on its stream of thinking. Mindfulness of emotions can be developed and practiced in many ways. Sitting down with someone to talk about how you feel is a good way to begin to be aware of emotions. However, as we are focused on words and describing them, we're still not getting right to the heart of the matter. In a conversation like this, it really helps to pause, let go of all the thinking, and direct your attention toward the feeling itself. So I invite you to take a few breaths, maybe focus on your breath as a way of trying to clear your mind and maybe make a transition to how you feel. We'll spend the next 10 minutes or so. I'm just going to leave you with this quote. The blue sky does not obstruct the white cloud's flight. The blue sky mind has room for everything to come and go.